Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate the new Discovery Connector nodes that have been added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.5. So, 7 new request nodes have been provided in 12.0.5, and they're all listed in the ACE documentation, as you can see here. So, we have the Amazon S3 request node, Cooper request node, IBM Cloud and Request Node, Microsoft Azure Blob Storage Request Node, IBM Maximo Request Node, Magento Request Node, and a new Salesforce Request Node. And we have tutorials for each of these request nodes too. In the tutorials gallery, if you search for Discovery, then you can see a tutorial for each of these request nodes, which will take you through how to configure them. Each node is configured and used in the same way, and I'm going to take you through how to use one of them today, which will be the Amazon S3 request node. Before I start creating my application and message flow, I'm going to show you some additions that we've made to the wizard for creating a test server. So I'm going to start the wizard, and in the wizard, you can see the usual options that you can select. I normally just leave the defaults. The new options we've added are at the bottom, so you can now specify a vault key. This allows you to specify that a vault should be created in the work directory for the test server to use. So I'll enter a vault key here. And the second enhancement we've added is now an option to not start the test server immediately. This allows you to make configuration changes that you may want to make in the server.conf.yaml in the work directory before the test server is started. So I'm going to deselect this checkbox here so that the test server is not started, and I'll click finish. So I can see the work directory has been created and the test server is in stopped state. So now I'm going to create an application, and I'll call it Amazon S3. And now I'll create my flow. So this flow is going to create an Amazon S3 bucket. So I'll call it create bucket. And now in the flow editor palette, you can see there are some extra drawers under connectors for the new request nodes that we've added. So I'm going to use the Amazon S3 request node. And each of these nodes has a consistent user interface and uses a wizard for allowing you to connect to the backend service. So the Amazon S3, which is short for Amazon Simple Storage Service, provides object storage, which uses the scalable storage infrastructure of Amazon.com. And you can access it from the AWS Management Console. I've opened the S3 Management Console. And in here, you're able to store objects, which you can download and also use data with other AWS services. And you can use the Amazon S3 request node to connect to Amazon S3 and issue synchronous requests to create, retrieve, update, delete, or view objects. So each object is stored in a bucket. So I'm going to create an initial message flow, which simply creates a bucket in Amazon S3. So I have a number of buckets already in my account. I don't have a bucket which has Sanjay in the name, so I'm going to create one in my message flow. In order to connect to the backend service, credentials are required, and these same credentials are needed for configuring the node while developing the message flow, and they will also be needed by the integration server while processing messages which are sent to the flow. So credentials are stored in the vault that is used by the integration server, and the credential is in turn referenced by policy, which is specified on the request node. So a policy is needed, and before I can create policy, I need to define a policy project. So I'm going to create a policy project, and I'm going to call it Amazon S3 policies. Finish there. Okay, so on the node, I have a button which says Launch Connector Discovery. I can open that, and I'm going to select the policy project Amazon S3 policies. You need to specify a work directory. So I have a test server, and I am going to use the test server work directory in this node. So the credentials that are created will be stored in a vault in this work directory. So I'll now click on Launch Discovery. This is the connector discovery wizard, and this will have a similar look and feel for all discovery connectors that are used in App Connect Enterprise. So I want to create a bucket, so I'm selecting Create Bucket, and I need to click on the Connect button to specify how to connect to Amazon S3. I need to provide a secret access key, and I need to specify a key ID. And now I can connect. So I've now been able to connect. I've selected the action to create a bucket, and now I can click Save. The action and object has been saved on my node configuration. So if I close the Discovery Wizard, I can see the node has been updated. So the basic tab shows the action and object that have been configured in the Discovery Connector Wizard. And on the App Connection tab, I can see the policy project and the policy that will be used. If I open up the policy in the policy editor, I can see that it has a reference to a credential which has been created in the vault. If I open a command console, I can run the mqsi credentials command, and by running this command I can see that this credential has been created in the vault, which allows me to access Amazon S3. So as well as creating a policy and credentials, JSON schemas are also saved in the project, in the application. So we have a request schema and a response schema. So the request schema can be used when configuring the message flow. So I can use a mapping node, which I'll do shortly. And there's a response schema as well. So if I now add a mapping node, I can specify the request schema to be used. And in the schema, I can specify the name of a bucket that should be used. So I'll assign it the name Ace Sanjay Bucket. And now I'll finish the configuration of the flow by adding an input and reply node so that I can drive the flow. So I'll just use an HTTP input node. And an HTTP reply node. And so in the HTTP input node, I'll give it the URL. So I'll put Amazon create bucket, and I'll specify that JSON is going to be sent in, and link up the HTTP reply node and save that. So my flow is complete now, and I'm ready to drive the flow. Before I do that, I'll show you another workflow which you can use to configure your connection to the backend services. So an alternative way is to select File, New, and select Discovery Connector Policies and Credentials. You can also access it from a policy project as well. So if I select this option and click Finish, you are shown a wizard which shows all of the different connectors that can be used. So these 7 are shown at the moment in 12.0.5. And you can see I've already configured a connection to Amazon S3. So it's showing the policy project and policy that is used. I haven't yet created connections for these other backend services. So I'm going to now start my server. And before I put a message through the flow, I need to deploy the policy project, which the message flow will be using. So the policy project has deployed, and now I will start the flow exerciser to send a message through the flow. So I'll just send an empty JSON message into the flow. And I can see that a response message has been returned. If I select a message in particular points in the flow, I can see that the bucket name was specified before the request node, and after the request node, I can see the name of the bucket that was created. So if I now return back to the S3 management console and refresh it and search for my bucket, I can see that my bucket was indeed created. and it's now ready for me to start adding objects into it. The bucket does not yet contain any objects, and we will start doing that in the next video. So in this video, I've shown how to configure and use a Amazon S3 request node. I've introduced you to the other Discovery connector nodes. And in the next video, I will show how to use some of the other features of a node for using different actions and objects.